Hi there, I'm Katie and welcome to the show. Today we're joined by Becky James, who's going to show us this beautiful winter scene card. It features loads of great inking, stamping, heat embossing and spritzing techniques that I'm sure you'll want to get to grips with. Hi Becky,
Hi, welcome along.
So you've got a beautiful winter scene that you're going to show us.
I am.
I know there's loads of techniques packed onto this one, so should we get started?
Yep, absolutely.
Brilliant. Right, what's first?
Right, first of all, I've just got a plain piece of white card. This is 300 GSM, so it's fairly strong because we're going to be piling paint and ink and all sorts of things on there. So we do need a nice strong backing card there. So I've got two Artiste paints that I'm going to use to start off with, and this is what we're going to use to make our background.
Okay.
So I'm going to start off with the Lagoon Blue. I'm just basically piling on, and I'm giving a good coverage here of the Lagoon Blue.
That's beautiful, that colour,
isn't it?
It is
it's like a really beautiful teal blue, isn't it?
Let's
just pull it up so everybody can see
it. Beautiful.
So it is, it's a really gorgeous colour. The next one is Night Blue. So this is what we're going to add on. Just to give it just the tonal shades, basically.
And we don't need to let this dry beforehand.
No,
I'm just going to.
No.
Okay, good.
Although you might find it, if you've got a porousy card, that it might start to seep.
Okay.
But if it does, and it's already drying, it doesn't really matter. We're not trying to blend it perfectly or anything like that. And don't worry about what way your strokes go on or anything like that. There's nothing special about it at all. As you can see.
Just keep going until you're happy.
Yeah, just keep going until you're happy. I'm perfectly happy with that now. Now, the next thing I'm going to use, this is the Artiste Blue Pigment Ink. And the reason I'm using this as opposed to a dye-based ink is that pigment inks, as their name says, are more highly pigmented.
Okay.
So when you blend them, you get a much more vivid colour. So what I'm going to do is I'm basically going to tone down a bit of this Lagoon Blue to be just a slightly darker, more ultramarine kind of colour.
Okay.
It is a nice technique and it does work really, really well. And you can use your stamp pad foam as well. And you're not trying to do anything perfect. I'm just blending it in. So let's quickly give that a bit of a heat set with my heat tool here. Ooh. I've just dropped my glue gun. Never mind. This is like crafting in my craft room at home. And all we're just doing, just drying that ink off a little bit. Right, so having done that, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to get stamping.
Oh, good.
Now, the stamps that I've got here, these are the new Bellissima stamps.
Oh, yes.
And I love this filigree tree.
That's stunning,
isn't
it?
It is. It's absolutely beautiful. So I'm going to use white pigment ink. And basically, we are just going to ink it up. I'm going to put my tree just slightly over the edge of my block, but you don't have to. If you want the tree completely in there, you can. And we're just going to lift that off. And there you go. It's
beautiful.
Really, really detailed.
That's lovely, isn't it?
It's really lovely. It's great because it's perfect for just jewelling up and adding some glitter glue to and that sort of thing.
Oh, yeah.
Which is what I've actually done in the design. Now, I know we normally go for a perfect impression and perfect application of the powder, but here it's probably maybe I've just missed a couple of bits of the pigment where it hasn't quite dried properly. That doesn't matter because we're looking for a blizzard effect.
Okay,
so the main thing is that I can see the tree quite clearly, but those little bits around the outside are fine. I'm going to add a bit more around the outside later, but we'll start and we'll get this embossed first. So all we do, just hold our glue gun a little bit above and just very, very quickly start to see it turn. Can you see the...
That's lovely, isn't it?
Yeah. Right, so I think looking at that, I've managed to cover it all. So we'll just turn that off. Go back to that again in a second. Right, now then, what I'm going to do is I've just got my white ink pad here. And I'm basically actually just going to rub it very roughly around the edges. It doesn't have to be perfect at all. If you want to, you can use a clear pad to do this as well, but it doesn't matter, I've got the white here, this is fine.
Mm-hmm.
And we're just basically gonna rub that around the edges. Don't worry if a little bit of the ink comes off on your white pad, because at the end of the day, when you use it next time, that blue won't come off, it's actually mainly the white that'll come through it. So. But can you see as I'm putting it, it's starting to build a frame round here, and it's very random almost. I tell you what it reminds me of, is if you're looking through a window and there's frost on the outside of the window.
Yes.
That's the kind of effect I'm looking for. So next thing we're doing, very, very quickly, we're going to do exactly the same, and we're going to heat these bits up. So what I've got now is each of my snowflakes I've got on two smaller blocks here.
Okay.
And I've put the three tiny ones actually onto one block. And I'm going to start off, first of all, by adding the larger snowflake in areas. Now what I have done here, actually, which just so that it doesn't go over my too much over my tree, is I've stamped the tree in black onto a post-it note, and you stamp it so that it partly goes over the tacky bit. And that's, I've cut this one out, but that is now a mask.
Oh.
So if I pop that over where my tree is, it means that anything that I stamp now will stamp onto the mask, so that when I lift the mask, it won't be within the design of the tree.
Okay.
So the tree will stay quite crisp.
So it'll look like this bit is behind.
Behind,
won't it?
Yeah, absolutely. That's exactly it. So I'm just going to ink this up. Now, I'm not going to apply quite as much ink now because I don't really want this to be as bright as the white when I was stamping it to get the main tree. I want it to be quite subtle. And I'm using my pigment ink again. There's no problem in doing that. But again, I just need to remember to heat set it.
Okay.
So, but you can see, I mean, the detail, I wonder if you can pick this up, but the detail in this snowflake
is
superb.
That's so intricate, isn't it?
Yeah. Now what I'm doing here is I'm adding the smaller snowflakes. So I'm just filling in spaces. And they're just exquisite.
Really beautiful.
They are absolutely exquisite. Now I've put three smaller ones together to use them all together, but you can individually use those and fill in the spaces. They're really, really beautiful, these are. And that's all I'm using the smaller ones for. I'm just looking to see where I've got a little bit of a space and just filling in.
Beautiful.
I'm just going to heat set these again. There's a lot of heat tool work in this one. But it's just to make sure that they don't smudge and that they stay nice and crisp. That will just set
beautiful.
That for me. And then I've just got one final thing that I want to do to this before I would set this then to one side just to dry. And that is, I'm going to use my white R2 spritz ink.
Ooh.
But we're going to do something a bit different. We're not going to actually use the spritz mechanism in it. So give it a good shake, nice ball bearing in there, so it'll make sure all your pearlescent pigment is nicely mixed in. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take that out and I'm actually going to tap it.
Ooh.
And this is like almost like your bright white snowflakes coming down. And you can control that. And you just get random snowflakes.
Lovely.
There. And that really then gives you your scene. Now, what I will say is, as these are drying, because the paints and the inks are water-based, don't worry if it brings through a little bit of the blue into the artiste, into the liquid the artiste pigment, the artiste spritz has in it. It's fine because all you'll do is you'll get a slightly bluey glow to your pigment.
Okay.
So you'll get this nice frosty blue rather than the bright white. So there you go. So that's
stunning.
Your actual scene. So on this, the next stage really is I've actually put round the edges some glitter glue, which is the iridescent one. And I squeeze a little blob onto some paper and pick it up with my finger and I just dab it on like that.
Do you find that gives you the most control?
Yeah, definitely. But I've also added some glitter glue onto the tree around the filigree.
Oh, yeah.
Now this one, I've actually used the Craft Planet little glitter glues, because these have, let me open this up so you can see it, these have the finest little nozzle so you can control
them. Just goes
them.
To show that just because it's a Craft Planet range doesn't mean it's just
no,
for children. So
absolutely.
They work wonderfully for grown-ups as well.
Yeah,
they
do as well. And then on the filigrees as well, I've added some silver adhesive gems too.
Beautiful.
Now I've already made my base of my card from earlier on. And this is basically, it's two of the Bellissima papers, which I've layered on top of each other. They're quite similar in colour, but they work really nicely together. One's got a more greeny tone, one's got the more tealy blue tone. And actually the colours work really well with the paints and everything
beautiful.
That I've used here. I've put a little bit of midnight not midnight blush at all, oyster blush, crochet trim around here, and some ribbon and baker's twine.
Lovely.
Now, when we've put this on here, you won't see a huge amount of this, but it just becomes part of the background of the design, and those little details really all add to it. So what we're going to do is, I've already got this ready. Now, I'll just show you as well on the back of here, I've left this area here without any foam on, because that's the bit that will go over where the border is, the fabric border, because with all that crochet and that ribbon, it's quite proud. It stands quite proud from the card. So, and because of that, I've got two layers of foam tape here.
Okay.
Because of course, if I had the foam tape in the centre there, what that would do is it would lift that centre, so it would bow.
Yeah.
It would actually bow. All right, let's get some glue on here so that if I need to, I can just manoeuvre it around a little bit. It's just my sticky glue stick.
Because that 3D foam tape is super sticky,
isn't it? So. It is super sticky. Once it is stuck down, it's not going anywhere. And I don't have the best of straight eyes, so it allows me to manoeuvre things around. And what we're going to do is, and I'm going to layer up a little embellishment on the side here, but what I really want to do is to show you how to frost the berries as well. So first of all, I've got some feathers here. I just pop a blob of glue on there, and we're just going to stick that down. And I've already got now these leaves. If you don't have the leaf die set, really get it. There are 14 different leaves in there, which go from exotic fern kind of leaves through to your English oak leaves and things like that, but through to your holly and your mistletoe.
Oh, the mistletoe.
Like that.
I was just
going to
say that. That's my favourite, I think.
Yeah,
they're really
I love that. I love the mistletoe, because then you can get some of the shimmer dots, you know, the lovely silver red shimmer dots, and put those there as berries or whatever else. Now then, next bit is my festive berries, and I am just in love with these. They come in gold and silver as well.
Yeah.
But the red ones, they're just gorgeous. They're almost good enough to eat.
They're the epitome of Christmas.
They really sum it up. They really are. Now, what we're going to do with these is, I've got some Paper Mania fine glitter here in the iridescent colour.
Okay.
And I've got here, this is the sticky glue pen, and it's basically PVA glue in a pen. And I'm just going to squirt some of that onto my mat. All I'm going to do, just with my finger, if you want to do it with a brush, if you don't, I'm...
You've got to get your finger in the PVA.
Yeah, that's it. I'm not worried about getting messy.
Might be in school.
It is, absolutely. And I'm just going to tap a bit on like that. And basically, I'm just going to twizzle it in my glitter. So I'm going to start off just... pop a blob of hot melt glue on the back there, and what I do is start by popping the first one in place, holding it until it sets, and then you can arrange them around each other basically. Now then, I've used actually here, this is the Bellissima jumbo ribbon. It's just a gorgeous
teal colour.
That is gorgeous,
isn't it?
It's this beautiful, beautiful teal colour. And then really, it's this kind of colour that was the inspiration really for me for the project, to be honest with you. So. That's where I started from. That was my starting point. Let's get the glue on the back there. And as I say, I'm going to pop that so that it sits over the stems of the berries.
Nice.
Now, there's one last little bit that I've got here to go on, and I do want to talk about this just briefly. This is actually using, from the Bellissima Ultimate Decoupage Pack, it's actually using the ribbon... they're like paper ribbon strips, you know, the card ribbon strips.
Yeah.
And I've cut one to make a banner here. But what I love to do is, if you actually look at the sentiments, quite often, if you can group sentiments together and you can make a larger or longer sentiment or wish to go on the front. And that's what I've done here. It says, to someone special with love. But it's basically just taking two and layering them together so that they overlap and they sort of all work together.
Making that unique sentiment.
Yeah, that's it. There we go, that's it. And that
beautiful.
Is our finished design.
Brilliant, well thank you so
much.
That's
a pleasure.
That's beautiful. I hope if I get one a bit like this for my Christmas card.
yes, I have to think about those yet, don't I?
If you've enjoyed Becky's project, we'd love to hear about it. Why not leave us a comment to tell us what you thought? If you've been making your own projects as well, we'd really like to see those. Why not upload them to docrafts.com, and Becky and I might pop over and leave you a little comment as well. There's a really good way to keep up to date with everything happening at DoCrafts. We have a Facebook page that we'd love if you'd like it. That would be great. You can find the details on screen now. Until next time, happy crafting.